Good morning, everybody. This is a new episode of our Humble Talks. And today I like to look a little bit on the topic of death. It is one of the main topics for every spiritual seeker, for every person who is alive on this planet, right? And of course, it is not a subject which we're going to handle down it in one talk. But it should be something you have to make friendship with it. Because this is a companion, this is an advisor, this is a solver for a lot of things in our life. And when you can allow yourself to be present with the thought of death, with a memory, with a reminder that death will come, that it is granted, that it is necessary, then you will have a lot of easiness in your life. For many people, to remember death is a kind of threat, it's a kind of knife which hangs over us, and we are afraid it can happen anytime, and we try actually to fight it. So death and birth is actually the same. There is no real death and there is no real birth. But for our situation here on Earth, you have first to understand there is two births and there is two deaths. The first birth is when your soul enters in the womb of your mother. And this is not an easy thing, because the soul has another expansion, has another state, has another freedom, another state of love, and so on and so on. And to enter into something and to squeeze the soul inside is not easy. In our tradition, it is said that when God commanded the soul to enter into the body of Adam, that the soul said, no, I cannot do that. It is too small, it is too much. And God was making the body of Adam to sound like a flute. And when the soul listened to that music, she was ready to enter. And this is the reason why when we hear, for example, the ney, the reed flute, we feel something in us which is longing and which wants to go with it. So then comes the physical birth, which is, of course, the beginning into this dream, let's call it like this, into this game, into this play, into this school. And when you are born, you forget. You forget yourself. Even before you have been born, you were telling to yourself, this time I do not want to forget. This time I will be present from the very first moment. But when you are born, and the moment you are born into the physical world, something is locked by the divine, you know, because the game cannot start otherwise. If you are already perfect coming, what is the point to come here? You understand? So there is a kind of forgetfulness inside of us. And through this forgetfulness, we create pain in our life. First, when the ego is still not so developed, not so strong, the child lives in a magic world. And you may remember that. Some of you may remember that you lived in a magic world. But finally, we have to follow the world of the adults, because the child is dependent on them, and the magic world closes. Then comes the sexuality, which is overwhelming us and entangling us very strong with the world as well. Relationships and the whole craziness of relationships which we have nowadays. Yeah, that the relationship is everything, that it has to become the center of our life, and that it is the fulfillment of our life, and that it is everything given what we are looking for. So then there is also two deaths. And the first possible death is what our Prophet, peace be upon him, said, die before you die. So there is a death which is the remembrance of your origin, the remembrance of your being, the remembrance of the source, of the force which is everything penetrating in our world. And when you are fully conscious about that, when you are fully in remembrance to your own self, to your higher self, to your real self, then in a way it is only possible to achieve that if something in you dies, the idealized image about you, about good and bad, about right and wrong, and so on, all this will disappear in a way, and you will find yourself back into your beingness, into your reality, and also the world, the outer world, will change completely in your perception. Like my master used to tell me that sometimes he sees golden lights over roofs of houses and golden rain coming down from heaven. And he had very often very different perceptions about the world. Then comes the physical death. For most of us, there will be not a death before. Then comes the physical death. And the physical death, again, is not really a death, it is also a birth. So what dies is the body, but we are a deathless being. There is no death coming to us, really. There is an ongoing transformation, an ongoing evolution in a way. And this is what happens. I don't want to go this time too much into the theme of what happens after and so on and so on. Because this is another very deep and big subject. Important is to understand that death can help you enormously to have things clear. So imagine for a moment that you would have only 1 hour left to live. Just 1 hour. What would you do? What would come in your mind? What would be your situation? What would you like to repair, maybe? What would you like to say to certain people? And if you find out concretely what it would be, then it is very advisable to do that. To do that as quick as you can. So the mirror of death brings you to the very essential points in your life, to the very essential aspects of your life, which you may not want to miss. Therefore, from time to time, do this practicing. Look in your situation and imagine that you have 1 hour left. What you will do in this 1 hour, what you would like to say, what you would like to act, maybe, and then do it. Do it as much as you can. And that will make you to really jump in your life, to really clean your life in many, many aspects. So death is an extremely valuable companion. It is the one master which has been given to us, to everybody, and which we fight him, and which we are ignoring him, and which we try to oppress him. And this is a very foolish behavior. So, my dear people, make death your companion. Make him your advisor. Make him your supporter. And you will find a new taste in life, a new joy in life, a new energy in your life. Thank you very much for your attention. Hear you soon again. All the best to you. Love and blessings to all of you. Thank you.